And all my life I've wanted to be famous.
You'd be hard-pressed to find another actor that can match Tom Hardy's rare combination of talent and mass appeal. Over the course of his stunning career, the London native has proven himself to be one of Hollywood's brightest stars. Tom Hardy's acting resume is rather remarkable.
Let's not stand on ceremony here.
He has taken on iconic fictional characters like Bane, Venom, and Max Rockatansky. He has portrayed notorious real-life figures like Charles Bronson, John Fitzgerald, and the Cray Brothers. And he has even showcased his talents on television with shows like Band of Brothers, Peaky Blinders, and Taboo. Tom Hardy is unique in the sense that he can cater to bizarre arthouse films as well as giant blockbusters. His talent and eccentricity make him perfect for small artful films where he can really flourish, but his celebrity and beloved presence make him a no-brainer when it comes to big studio films. An interesting parallel is that Hardy is best associated with playing powerful, intimidating characters, but he admits to being quite the opposite in real life. When discussing his masculinity, Hardy stated, "I don't feel rugged and strong and capable in real life, so I seek it, to mimic it and maybe understand it, or maybe draw it into my own reality. People who are scary, they terrify me, but I can imitate them." Perhaps this is one of the best validations of Hardy's ability as an actor. The fact that he embodies menacing characters so well, when he is admittedly very different.
Leave us.
No, you stay here. I'm in charge.
Do you feel in charge?
And despite breaking out of this character mold in a variety of ways, Hardy has been labeled as the strong silent type, thanks to films like Lawless and Mad Max Fury Road, where he seemingly mumbles and grunts more than he actually speaks. But Hardy actually has an impressive array of voices and accents at his disposal.
We will no longer bow before anyone as slaves.
Yeah, them engines down Texas way. You know, they may rob you, ain't gonna take your top knot.
Don't moan about it, right? It's done, isn't it?
Oh, I have a parasite. They can hear everything. There is a reason why they sent me, you understand?
I told them that this was the reason why I had not come home. It wasn't that I defected or anything.
Then you have my permission to die.
One of my favorite Tom Hardy performances is the one that he gives in Nicholas Winding Refn's Bronson. Refn seemed to realize Hardy's many gifts early on in his career. The film brilliantly utilizes Hardy's menacing, formidable side, as well as his eccentric, theatrical side.
Britain's most expensive prisoner!
I'd be remiss if I didn't mention Hollywood's infatuation with covering one of its most handsome and recognizable faces.
No one cared who I was till I put on the mask.
From The Dark Knight Rises, to Mad Max Fury Road, to Dunkirk, to Venom, Hardy seems to spend a great deal of time with his face at least partially hidden. It seems that filmmakers aren't too concerned about covering Hardy's face because he is so gifted when it comes to isolated expressiveness.
You know, I said to Tom, let's just see what you can do with, you know, just your left eye. And of course, being Tom Hardy, what he does with just his left eye, I think is pretty remarkable.
Take Bane, for example. With the lower half of his face completely covered, Hardy could only use his eyes to convey emotion. Even without the aid of music or dialogue, we can comprehend the feelings that Hardy is communicating just by observing his eyes.
You want that thing off your face?
While his masked roles get all the credit for his masterful expressiveness, Hardy brings this same level of nuance to all of his roles. Maybe the biggest affirmation to Hardy's expressiveness and all-around acting ability is the film Locke. Locke is basically an hour and a half of Hardy driving and talking on the phone. He's the only character we see on screen, and save for a few inserts and exterior shots, our eyes are locked on him the whole time. But what's amazing is that the film is actually captivating. And while this is surely attributed in part to the writing, the main reason the film works is because of Tom Hardy. Having to stay seated with no face-to-face interaction, Hardy somehow still delivers a powerful performance that keeps us entertained during something as monotonous as riding in a car. Tom Hardy is hands down one of the most brilliant actors working today. He is gifted and passionate and never not fun to watch. And of course, no Tom Hardy video would be complete without mentioning his obsession with dogs. Enjoy.